Are you looking for some homeschool curriculum ideas to homeschool your pre-kindergartner or first grader? For preschool or for pre-K, this is the Peaceful Preschool. I've done a whole episode dedicated to it. It's play-based, hands-on. Check out that episode. I'll make sure I link it below. For reading, if you have a first grader, I am going to be doing the All About Spelling Level 1. I'm also looking into a program called All About Reading, and I'm trying to decide if we're going to do Level 1 or Level 2, but this is Level 2, and it also comes with a leap into reading, and there's a whole lot of other things it comes with, but I'll make sure I link it below if you want to see more. I also put the Teach Your Child to Read in 100 Easy Lessons because we're actually still finishing this up. There is an upgraded cover, but this is effective. I started this with when my child was in kindergarten, well, actually the end of his pre-K year, took it real slow, and he's almost done now and he's reading. So just wanted to plug that in. For writing, I use a journal. In addition to, I love these prompts that is mentioned in the 180 days of writing for first grade. And it's very engaging and interactive. And it just sparks, a love for writing. I love the prompts in there. For math, we are going to be using Spectrum Hands-On Math. And one of the things that I really like in the back of this one is that in the back, there is a dry erase clock. You also have your different tens grids. You have some charts you can use. And throughout all the ways of learning math, it's hands-on. And it has some things for you to punch out. So you already have the manipulatives with you and you can put in the little pouch. And I just think math should be hands-on. And that's why I really liked this here, the Spectrum. Also, for science, I am revisiting the human body. This is a book where they can put stickers to match their body parts and help them learn that. I also use classical conversations, which is good for a lot of different things, geography, history, grammar, and there is communities all over the nation. So if you want to join a community, you should look into classical conversations. For the Bible, I have been using this since my kids were babies, and I just love how it grows with them. And this is one of the Bibles, not all of the Bibles, but I love the Pray and Play Bible because it includes songs and lots of hands-on activities. Again, I have another video if you want to see like the inside and details. Both of my kids are in Spanish clubs, so I tried to find some really cool Spanish books. We have on Amigo, de Veras, Maravilloso. I probably just chopped up that title, but you get what I'm saying. And then this other book is called Fiesta. And so if you want to look into those Spanish, so that is just a snapshot of what I plan to be using. Let me know in the comments below, was there anything that you saw that you're like, ooh, I want to look into that. And let's finish this conversation in the comments. If I decide to add a little bit more, I'll make sure that I, add those things in the description box. So just check out the description box for all the resources. And there might be more that I didn't talk about in the video that I remember after the episode to put in the description box. So talk to you guys soon. Bye.